Hey guys, and welcome back to another brand new Jujutsu Kaisen video. And yes, I'm a bit late on this one, unfortunately. But trust me, this video will be quite long of a review video because I would like to actually talk about my thoughts on Geto's new path and also his character as a whole. Of course, I'm talking as an anime-only watcher, so I might get some point wrong and such, but please do correct me if I'm wrong. Alright, so let's just get straight into the review for the content of the episode itself. The finale episode of Hidden Inventory arc is here, and this episode is actually the episode with the most content so far. Don't get me wrong, it's not like the previous few episodes doesn't have the quote-unquote content or anything. It's just that this episode gave so much more information about stuff that I personally want to know, and I get to know more of Geto's character as a whole as well. The explanation of this one particular character that I would like to know on why he became like this. Don't worry, I'll also be talking about the direction, storyboards, and also the animation in a bit, because these few aspects also carried the episode as a whole, but let's just leave that at the end of this video, right? Now, let's talk about Geto's character. I got to admit it, he does have a point. I'm not saying that I support his action of killing non-sorcerers to make a world where only Jujutsu sorcerers exist, but I'm not saying that it is impossible as well. As Geto mentioned in the episode, if it's Gojo that has his perspective of thinking, it is definitely not impossible to execute the plan since he is the Gojo Satoru. At the same time, killing innocent non-sorcerers, or we can just call them normal human being, is just wrong. Of course, Geto's mindset during the past has always been wanting to save the non-sorcerers. Them as the strongest need to save the weak. Now that he has seen the bad sides of it, he immediately have the new mindset of there's no point of protecting or saving the weak non-sorcerers, which in my opinion is definitely not wrong at all. Not everyone has to live by the principle of quote-unquote you need to save everyone. But again, killing non-sorcerers to have a world where only Jujutsu sorcerers can exist is just a selfish behavior. I get it, Geto has a point now. He's doing something that is finally worth having an answer to the question, why? But again, it is still just messed up. Sure thing, Geto went through a lot, which explains why he chose another path that is pretty much messed up. But again, kinda makes sense. His conversation with Yuki definitely played quite a major role on why he ended up pursuing what he is doing right now. As an antagonist of a show, he is definitely a solid one with a goal that has a point. But also, the fact that their current system set by the higher ups are also messed up explains even further why the burnout, used and exhausted Geto decided to choose his own path of growth. Even with his new goal, his personality never changes. Like in the episode, he looks happy when he meets Shoko. Like, his personality is still there. He doesn't oppose any threat towards Jujutsu sorcerers. Even with the two kids in the village that he burned, he is so sweet to them. Like, look at this, man. This literally showcases that he knows what he is doing will not affect how he interacts with people he is fine with. But at the same time, the path that he is going with is just, again, messed up. Geto as a character is definitely something that is very much interesting to see, but at the same time, it's just sad to see him go with this path of the way. Also, for some reason, the Hayabara guy with less than 5 minutes of screen time just randomly died in this episode. Yeah, sure, it's most likely to show Geto how much of a pile of body there might be if he continued with his old goals. But again, this arc definitely built up more of my interest towards this particular series. And also, at the end of the episode, we finally got the reappearance of the present time main cast, Itadori, Megumi, and Nobara. Also, a great callback to the opening as they showed Gojo sleeps on the chair in the opening. And then for the last scene, it's just Gojo waking up and seeing them. As a whole, this arc has been very fun. This anime ranking for me, personally, has gone up in the list. Of course, I haven't made any official list yet, but please do let me know if you guys want to see me making a list though. But yeah, this arc has increased my love for this one particular anime as a whole, and I am looking forward to watch the infamous Shibuya arc. And also, I just recently watched the Jujutsu Kaisen Zero movie, which I finally got the time to watch and it was incredible. Please do let me know if you guys want me to make a review video for this particular movie, even though it has been quite a while since the release of it. But yeah, please do let me know. Now to the direction aspect of the episode by Atsushi Nakagawa, Takuya Ninuma, and Sota Yamazaki. First of all, apparently I got the name wrong for the main director in the goodness video. I got confused between the Jun and Atsushi, since apparently it's pretty common to get these two surnames mistaken apparently. But yeah, a very solid and well-directed episode as a whole, from the very start till the very end. Some scenes that I would like to mention is definitely the ghetto stinking scene in the bathroom while showering. The way they use the heavy water droplet sound and slowly increasing the volume definitely make the scene even more intense than it already is. Ghetto's going to mission alone on the train was very well presented as well, really shows how isolated and exhausted he is while doing his duties as Jujutsu sorcerers. The scene where Gojo confronted Ghetto in front of KFC was very well done as well. The continuous cut between their dialogues and a random truck passing by again adds up more intensity to the scene as a whole. Ghetto burning his hometown village was directed perfectly as well. The way the two grown-ups are shouting, the OST, the effects used on their voice, the silhouette to show Ghetto's moves, everything was done very well. They did an incredible job with the entire episode, and this episode definitely feels very enjoyable to watch from the very start till the very end. Next up, we have the storyboards by Shota Goshozono. With a great direction comes the great storyboards. Very fresh and appealing storyboards by Gozo himself, and it is no doubt that he will always deliver episode with the most interesting looking storyboards. The way of angle that has been used, the scene that has callback to the previous episodes and such, everything was done beautifully by Gozo himself. Without his beautiful and one-of-a-kind type of storyboards, this episode itself wouldn't have looked as interesting as it is. To be really honest, I'm not even sure what I should be talking about anymore, because Gozo's storyboards are just too good. There are too many words to be used to express them. As I mentioned in the goodness video, no matter what type of episode it is, either it is action-packed or heavy dialogues, he will always deliver it flawlessly. Now for the arts and animation aspects of the episode. This also plays a very major role to make an episode look appealing. Something that I don't really understand though is the fact that some people are saying they are using too much CGI in this episode, which is absurd as I don't see much usage in this episode. And if there is, it is mostly for backgrounds. But as far as I know, I don't think the characters are in CGI or anything. But that's a video for another day. That is if I'm still motivated to do so. Alright, first of all, the art in this episode looks great. With the simplified design, the way the characters drawn definitely has been a big benefit for them and also makes them look way better in the episode. Sota Yamazaki and Ninuma's correction can definitely be seen here and there during the entirety of this episode. The quality of each drawing are just top tier, man. The way they drew exhausted Ghetto was definitely out of the world. Just by a glimpse of it, even though you don't even watch the show, you can literally tell that this man went through a lot of shit in his life. But unfortunately, some people actually mistaken these drawings as CGI, which is understandable as Yamazaki and Ninuma are too good at drawing that it looks lively. Overall, this episode definitely has the strongest art direction in the entirety of this arc for sure. As for the animation, I never knew they would go this hard for a heavy dialogue episode. Again, the movement looks too fluid and people even thought it is CGI'd. Unfortunately, there isn't that much of name that has been credited in Sakugaboru, so I'll just mention the scenes with their name on it. First one being the smooth ass Gojo playing with pen animation by Daniel Kim, and bro has no reason to make the scene looks that good, but I am not complaining. We also have Hisashi Mori's cut from the ghetto burning the hell out of his village, which the blue flower looks incredibly good. And we also have Shoichi's cut when someone, who I assume is Principal Yagi, looking at the report and straight cut to Ghetto meeting the people in the village. We also have Sota Yamazaki's incredible character acting cut of Ghetto's speech, which undoubtedly the coldest scene in the entirety of the episode. The way Ghetto moves, the fluidity is there, it looks too smooth that some people thought it was CGI. The microphone that has been thrown, everything was incredible. And unfortunately for most of the other cuts are uncredited. But overall, they did an incredible job. This episode definitely delivered the best content so far, and as a whole, I really enjoyed this arc. There's 3 weeks left until the very first episode of the infamous Shibuya arc, and I am yet still holding back to read the manga. But should I really wait and take the risk of getting spoiled, or should I just read the manga? Also, I want to mention my favorite line of this episode as the closing of this video. So there is no thank you very much and such, I'm going to end with this line.
君は五条悟だから最強なのか、最強だから五条悟なのか。